Just a month ago, everyone was hyped about the new AI photo editing tool DragAN. Even I hopped on the hype train and made a video about it with my specific sense of humor.
You know what a guy who actively used DragAN is called? Drag queen.
But those were just reviews without releasing the actual tool. And today it happened. DragAN was released on GitHub. Using my super programming skills, I have already been able to try it out, and the result will amaze you. Just believe me. As a bonus, here is also a tutorial, and I attach a Google Colab Notebook, when you can run the model by yourself. But that will be a little later. But now I would like to shatter all the high expectations of the people who didn't delve into it much, and some of them were deceived by the media. As far as I'm concerned, few people truly understand what DragAN is and what it's used for. Today I slept a full 6 hours, so yeah, evidently I'm full of sense and energy, which means we will cover everything in this video and understand it all. If you open the original article, you will probably understand that you don't really want to read it. Plus, there are illustrations here that seems to explain everything. What's the problem? Open a picture, mark it here, drag it there. But the problem that is not a picture is a GAN-generated image. GAN-generated image refers to an image that is generated by Generative Adversarial Network, in other words GAN. And GAN is type of artificial intelligence model, which consists on two main components, a generator and discriminator. The generator's purpose is to create new images that resemble a given training dataset, while discriminator's role is to distinguish between the generated images and real images from the training dataset. So you can just take any picture you like and manipulate it. To edit a real picture, you need to first perform GAN inversion using a specific tool. GAN inversion for a real image is a process attempting to reconstruct the input data that would lead to the generation of synthesized image similar to the original one. It involves manipulating the input data in order to achieve desired outcome using pre-trained GAN model. Exactly this helps us to understand the specific data required to create a particular image. So in simple terms, for each image you need to train a specific GAN model or use a technique called GAN inversion. In GAN inversion, you take an existing pre-trained model and train to create your image. The result will heavily depend on the original model itself and how different it is from the source image. For example, if model is pre-trained on athletes, then GAN inversion with the image from fashion show will be less successful. It also should be noted that the GAN inversion process requires a lot of computing power. So yeah, DragAN is not a magic wand, it does not do anything revolutionary. Before DragAN, edits in the GAN images could also be generated via manually annotated training data or prior 3D models, as authors write it in the very beginning of the article. DragAN just made it more convenient. I tried to simplify this matter as much as possible. I hope I didn't make any major mistakes in this simplification. I think I could try a smart inversion of my image if that video would be interesting for you. But for now, there are two models available in the GitHub repository with a person and landscape, so we can play around with them.
We in a DragAN Colab notebook, which I make it partially for you, and it will be available in a description down below. It works very simple. Just run each cell consequently, the next one after finishing previous one. That's it. There is three cells. First one, install all requirements. Second, install models, pickle files. And third one, it's run our DragAN Gadio app. That's it.
We install our requirements. Now we should download models. We download the models from specific script, which contained in a GitHub repository of DragAN. But I use also another models. You can download any pickle file you want. Just change link in the code, or just let me know in the comments that you want me to do that. We download all that models. As you can see, they are not small because, as I said before, it's not images, it's models. On the elephant models, for example, takes 400 megabytes. We just download our models, and now it's time to run our DragAN.
We just ran our DragAN and here we have public URL. Click this link and we in a gradual interface. Here we go. Here we can choose our pre-trained model, so-called pickle file. We have here several models like cat, dogs, lions, horse and others. So let's take this one, lions, on his nose and let it be here. Generation process just started. Feel free to experiment with DragAN, but to my mind it's too slow, it's almost unusable. It's quite lagging sometimes, there's too much glitches, artifacts, it's very slow. It's very slow with Google Colab GPU, which is very powerful, it's Tesla T4, but still it's very slow. You can choose models with lower resolution. It will work way more better, but still not so good. I experiment with other models, not from this specific file, specific script from repository. And that works way more better because there is very low resolution. But I think it's fun to use to make that kind of dinosaur girl, but still it's not usable in a long run. It's very funny to see those clickbaiting news. This is completely change photo editing. It's replacement for Photoshop, but it is not replacement. It's just specific tools for specific use case. That's all. At the same time, quite important to know that movements, changing of the model solely depends on dataset, training dataset. In case of that woman, it's very easy to make skirt shorter, but there is problem with some specific poses, which not so typical for dataset which used for training this model, which was fashion journals, I suppose. And exactly this strongly determines your ability to change photos.
Thanks for watching. I hope that video was helpful for you. Leave your ideas in the comment section down below. Thank you.